Greetings again, my friends, in the name of the Triune God who is always with us. I'm Debbie Bartley, honored to serve as one of the associate pastors of First St. Charles United Methodist Church. And today I draw to a close my thoughts on spiritual disciplines, spiritual practices, those things that can help us better experience God's grace and love, and help us to better share them with others. So if you've delved into one or more of these practices I've shared, I'd love to hear in the comments which ones and how it went for you. The final spiritual practice I'd like to talk about is celebration. And we celebrate so many things in our lives. And indeed, we are learning how to celebrate in new ways right now, aren't we? You know, we celebrate God's presence in our lives. We celebrate the good news of Jesus Christ, and we celebrate the life-giving, life-sustaining breath of the Holy Spirit. And we celebrate our next steps in our faith journeys and our transformations as we strive to be better persons, to be the people God created us to be. And I'd like to share a scripture. And then I'll share my featured friends today and why I'm featuring them. Our scripture is Isaiah 40, verses 28 to 31, which is an offering of celebrating of God's presence in our lives, of God's guidance in our lives. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. I often share this text at graveside services as a reminder of the powerful presence and strength of God in our lives. And we can always look to God for strength, guidance, and love. So, as we celebrate our ongoing faith journeys, I'd like to introduce you first to Hey Hey, the affable ditzy rooster from Disney's movie Moana. The heroine of the movie Moana feels a calling, but she has no idea where or what it is. Her father is the chief of the tropical island village, and her parents and community have become entrenched and immobile out of fear of the unknown. The island's resources are dwindling. So while Moana's dad is training her to be his heir in leadership, she feels drawn away from the island. So disobeying her father, which is not something I am promoting, Moana sets out on an adventure. And in the process discovers not only who she is, but what she is called to do. So she returns home and shares this with her parents. And through her leadership, they all leave the island, traveling to a better place. So the video clip included one of them with this devotion is the finale of Moana's reunion and the adventure of her people as they leave their new home, embrace their new calling. And the song is just plain uplifting. So I hope you'll take a moment and watch it. And I share this with you as an example of what our faith journeys can be like. You know, we know something just isn't right. Maybe we are just feeling a little down. Our spirits, there's an emptiness within a side of us. There's something we feel more to learn. We want to know. And practicing the spiritual disciplines and being a part of a faith community and serving with others and serving others helps us find who we are and what it is we can do to make a difference in our world and to make the world a better place. Now, my other friend is Figment, because why not? Figment is a quirky purple dragon full of imagination and creativity, and he invites us to open our minds to possibilities rather than to stay stuck thinking that the way we've always done things is the way to keep doing them. Figment reminds me to let it go and to think about life and its possibilities in new ways. And indeed, during this time of pandemic, I hope that you are embracing the creative side of yourself, cultivating creativity in yourself and those around you as we continue to adapt to our lives as they are right now. But more importantly, pandemic or not, we need to embrace our creative side, to look to God for guidance, to be open to God's nudges, and to rely on God for the strength to respond to the nudges. Will you pray with me? Dear God, we give you thanks for this day, and we give you thanks for our lives. We continue to lift up the presence of COVID-19 in our lives, the horrendous number of those who are ill with it, have been ill with it, and who have died from it. Comfort us in our losses. Comfort us in our fear. Give us the strength to rely on you, to listen for your nudges, to follow your nudges. Help us to be the people you know that we can be. And I pray all of this in Jesus' holy name. Amen. So let's remember Isaiah's words, that those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall not run. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. My friends, let's continue to stay safe. Let's continue to connect with each other as we connect with God. And let's continue to share God's love with everyone today, tomorrow, and every day. God bless.